Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean, The Legend of Heroes Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Left, Cavarro. Actually, fled Cavarro last episode. And now we're here in Marcha. So, I just got here. I've not looked around yet, so let's do that. Grandpa Wayan says, "The mountain range in the north is said to be the end of the earth. I don't know if it's true, since I've never confirmed with my own eyes." Garen says, "I heard the canceled performance at the International Theater was held for the soldiers." Yes, you heard correctly, but maybe not for the reason that you might have thought. It's like caviar to the general. It was such a waste. Huh? Oops, I mean casting pearls before the general. Yeah, we trapped them in there so that the girl could escape. Whose name I forget? The girl at the lake? Aye. Kasek. Saying, "There are two big cities in Marcheros. One is Cavarro in the east, the other one Ecule in the west." Oh, cool. I wonder if we're going to Ecule at some point. Cavarro is reasonably big. Cavarro is bigger in size. Okay. Ecule is more relaxing. Okay, good to hear. The village of Marcha is in between Cavarro and Ecule, so that's my boast. What? Are you saying so what? That's the dog. He said it under his breath. Run? Her name's Run. You know that song, Run? The song with, well, there's other music playing. It's like, dun, 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 run! Dun, dun, dun. That's a good song. "I went shopping to Cavarro, but the soldiers of Numeros didn't let me inside the city." How rude. What do they think they are? Even though there are soldiers from a different country. They probably think they're soldiers from a different country. Come here, green hair. Cheyenne says, "Do you know about a stone slate in the field? It's fun to hit it. If you hit it, it trembles for a while, making a booming sound. That stone slate looks more like being made of metal." Huh. I wonder what they're talking about. Is it one of the shrines, maybe, with the that have the resonance stones? Okay, so I went here. Oh, we have to check to make sure we can't just walk around under. They're tricky like that, you know? You can, like, enter through hidden areas. Hmm. Alright. Looked here, yeah. Alright. Didn't see nothing there, and I talked to them. This is my favorite part. Looked all over the place, I don't know why. Can't control ourselves. Grandma Croto says, "Greetings, traveler. Would you like some threads? 12 colored embroidery threads. I have some of the threads, especially for puppets as well." "Wow, they are colorful," says Una. "They are all good quality," McBain says. "Ho ho, take your time." Clunk, clunk, clank, clunk. "Spinning wheel which starts to turn. White thread, blue thread, and gather the two? What color will it be when it's done spinning?" "It will be watercolor when it's done." Clank, clunk, clank, clunk. Alright then. You're a little crazy over there. What else maybe here? Alright, we've reached the northern end. North Prairie. Dead end ahead. Watch for the monsters. Mm-hmm. Watch for the monsters. Hmm. That's her. Yeah, we'll go look in here. I try not to miss a place. Miss a house. Jill says, the Numero soldiers are bossing everyone in around in Cavaro. I wish they would go away soon. Yeah. The monsters which attacked Cavaro were dolls made of wood. Speaking of a doll, it reminds me of the Rosette's workshop in Ekul. Don't tell me the dolls of Rosette's workshop have gone out of control. I'm not telling you any such thing. They like to scream out, I'm a real boy, as they attack. You want to stay overnight? No. The bartender says, the news said that the Numero soldiers got rid of the wood soldiers which had attacked Cavaro. I'm impressed that they risked their lives for the people of a different country. That's misinformation. Yeah, everyone is like, I guess, just staring at him. The Numero soldiers are getting on our bad side, but they could be helpful. Oh, was that an attempt to placate the masses? They're getting on our bad side? Hold on a second. My little gamepad is all... the wire is all tangled. We can't have that, can we? Anything else to say? Oh, I just say that now. Didn't talk to her, did... No, we did. We talked to him. Okay. Nothing in there. There's another entrance or exit out that way. Ekul is west. We knew that. Alright, so I'm interested about this Ekul already. Let's see if there's anything hidden we can get ourselves into. No. Alright, what about this? Oh! Weapons! Weapons! Flash spear. Wait. So I guess no one can use a spear at this point. Spear with a polished sharp tip flashes it takes out its enemy without fail. We're not gonna buy it yet because we don't have someone that would use a spear. I guess he already has this sword. You, boss, you has that. Fighter glove. Medium shield. Chest guard. Yeah, this... all stuff we apparently already have except for the spear, which we don't need. We'll probably be picking up a party member that could use the spear? But I can't ascertain that, so... I don't want to waste the money if we don't... Doll Knight 14. The cost of a lie. Okay, that's a new one. Give me one of these. Give me two of these. Yeah, we have plenty of the other stuff, I think. I think. Is this somewhere? No. Is that it? Have we seen this entire place? I guess so. Are we just leaving then? Do we want to go to the dead end with the monsters? I mean, I don't know. This has me feeling very nervous. Let's put a save in. hoping you guys can hear me over the music, because I have trouble hearing me over the music. But that's because probably my own personal sound settings, which wouldn't carry over to you. Oh, hopefully it's working alright. 23. Yes, overwrite the data. Alright, dead end, monsters? Grass barrier. Or maybe there's a chest or something there. These monsters are all afraid of us. Oh wait, are they? Well, make up your mind. You want to fight or not? Alright, that looks like a whole bunch of stuff over there. Let's look up here. I just try to eliminate the short ways before continuing on, but it doesn't always work that way. Are you sure this is the dead end? That goes to a different zone. I almost ran into that. I see you. I'm trying to get out of my way while walking directly in my way. Air armor. Nothing. I want to see what it says before we compare. Armor blessed by the power of wind. Superior protection against wind spells. Oh, okay. It's an improvement by 3 points. Nice. Sold. Okay. Don't be sad, little monster. We will leave you be. Alright, so we got another zone up there, right? And then... oh, we got... oh, that is a dead end. It looked like we could go down there. Oh, we can go over here. Never mind. Oh, we can go here. There's a dead end. Emerald! We got an emerald. I always check because sometimes there's extra stuff in there. What's an emerald for? Is that just an item? Emerald? Oh, we have one already. Oh, we can sell it to shops. Light. Green, clear jewelry. So I forgot to sell the other one. Alright, so that's it for that. Yeah, this was the short way. So I should have gone that way first. Right, and I've been over here. Down here is the other chest, right? Making sure it's not another way. Yeah. Hello. Did I frighten you? Does this go down into? Nope. Whoa, that was a... I'm like, are you loading something? Let me check over here. The way it stuttered like that... Let me just restart the recording really quick, because... stutters cause desync. Hold on. Okay. We continue on. Really? Three screens up. Oh my! That's a really big tuning fork. It's a stone monument, says McBean. It looks very old. It looks like one of the tuning forks that we've, you know, been encountering, but a lot bigger. Something is carved on it, says Forte. Let's see, McBean says. Well, he says, let's see. McBean read the words on the stone monument. Gather two strands of colored thread and spin the supreme weaving yarn. Oh, we're going back to the old lady. What does this mean? Asked Forte. Do you think there's a resonance stone here? But Forte, says Una, there's no crest of Leon here. McBean says, this monument's letters are much older. They don't look like something done by Leon. Aria, no answer. That's her name. Forgot. There's a holy land ahead, she says. Eh? Says Una. We don't reject anyone's visit. But they can't go in unless they come by their own ability. The truth lies there. Song of Invitation, Aria's solo. It's a very unusual singing voice. Sorry, I'm slurping some iced coffee. McBean says, wow. She disappeared, says Forte. McBean says, most likely this stone monument is connected to a holy land of the water tribe. Okay, is she going to come back? Do you want to go after her, says Forte? She says the truth lies there. I think she has invited us. Besides, I assume that one of two resonance stones is there. However, we have to get there by our own ability. What does that mean? We have to disappear like she did, says Forte. Una says, but how? McBean says, right after the stone monument resonated in harmony with her singing, she disappeared. Alright, so we as the McBean company need to pay our own little resonant harmony. It looks like you'll be transferred if you play a certain melody. Forte says, it's like a resonance stone that vibrates the resonance stone. If Miss Aria is a descendant of the water tribe, this trick makes sense. So the resonance stones we're collecting are something reproduced by Leon in imitation of the water tribe's spells. Forte says, that means all we have to do is play the same melody as Miss Aria did. McBean asks, Forte, do you think you can catch the sound after listening just once? Hold on. I think I can do it. It's the same song of invitation. Yeah. Well, shouldn't that just take Forte? Una says, Forte, you're awesome. You did it in one shot. I'm surprised, too. I really didn't think I was able to play it correctly on the first attempt. McBean says, I guess you're rewarded with good results from your training a little. Stand by a second. Okay. It proves that your ears are becoming ones like the performers. Well, how's it go next? I don't know. We have to step on all these in a certain order. Right, let's do this one first. I don't know. Oh, that one's colored in blue. We got turquoise and like an off-white. I don't know. Let's do this one. We're in the same spot. Okay, let's do this one. Alright, try this one. Oh, now we went back? Did we go back? Is this a different area? No, right? That would be tricky if it brought us into an identical area and we were like in a new spot but didn't know. Yeah, hopefully they wouldn't do that to us. Gather two strands of colored thread and spin the supreme weaving yarn. Choose three threads in the correct order, right? I guess so, says McBain. There should be an order to be able to get to the holy land of the water tribe. Forte, why don't you try one more time? Okay. We didn't like blue. What are the order of the threads? Did that old lady give us something? I'm supposed to get the clue from her, I bet. Let's try this one. Or we could just brute force it. Well, that wasn't it. We didn't like that one, so we'll go here, blue, and then turquoise. Ooh. Okay. Like our sneakers are getting all wet. Wow, what is this place? The water tribe are here? You know, the secret passages and the... Well, here we've got another tuning fork. Alright, what's over the other way? We can get out of the water. Oh, there's a chest. With an exclamation mark. Let's check that out last. Will be just about now. So that's the one that brought us in. The resonant stone of March. It says March. Makes sense, it was by Marcha. Looks like this will make us agile, says McBean. You'll be able to move faster than the monsters. At any rate, says Una, how come the resonance stone is in such a place? We can ask Arya later, says McBean. Forte and his friends open the chest one more time and examine what was inside. A thorough search of the chest revealed a Sono Memory 24 still inside. Nothing different in particular. That's where the Orb of Ocean sounds. Huh? Which one we just picked up? 24, I guess? Tiny piece storing music from the past plays Town of Eternal People. This one plays What's With You Man, and this one plays Tear of Vermilion, My Dear Mel. I love these little references to the other games. Alright, so now we just have to go to this tuning fork and I guess advance further? Into the cavern or something? It says that again. Forte, do you want to carry that tune? Says McBain. No. No, let's do it later. Okay. Let's do it now. They're sleeping? McBain says, I guess we are finally here. But where is here? Jan's going, squeak. Una says, a flower garden? Forte's asking, where are we? We can walk out of it. We're going to be imprisoned in flowers. Oh. Who are these people? The village man says, it was true. Outsiders came to this village. Just like Arya said, says a village woman. Hi there, we're the McBain Company, says McBain. We're not suspicious people, so don't worry. The village old woman says, Arya told me about you. She said a group of troubadours would come here soon. You don't have to worry either. Arya is in the hut of Chief Oratorio. Chief Oratorio. We are not worried because you're Arya's guests. I welcome you. This is the first time that outsiders came into this village. Today is a memorable day for the hidden village of Shulf, historically. Shulf, huh? Chief Oratorio's hut is located at the north end of the village. Arya should be waiting there, too. Please go visit there. We will. We will, Grandma. We will. To the north, huh? Well. I love the stone bookcases. Pretty cool. So we're gonna explore everywhere else before we go to the hut. You know how it is. Actually, there's not much here. Hello? The village girl says, yeah! Miss Arya is back! Let's ask her to sing for us. Hmm? What's this fuzzy thing? The girl is looking at Jan with a confused look. She's never seen a dog before, says Forte. Wow, it's so fuzzy. That was... Stop torturing poor Jan. Hello, welcome. You're the ones who helped Arya. Please make yourself at home. Alright. We're sleeping in your bed, pronto. You're the ones who saved Arya. Arya is one of a kind to us. Thank you very much for saving her. I definitely wasn't expecting this. I thought we were just going to look around in Marcha's, or Marcha, rather, and then head on to the next place. Well, I got some kind of item shoppy here. Lackety paste. Yeah, I don't need any of that. All right. Alright, so we're going north. Somewhat? Okay, across the bridge. Una says, Forte, look! That way! What? Ah, let's go! Oh my. Awesome. Wow! What a view! Okay, so this is the Gagharv, for those who don't know, this is why it's, I don't even know if it's officially or if it's unofficially called the Gagharv Trilogy. But yeah, basically we might be looking at the two other lands that contain the stories of Tyr Vermillion and, the witch. What's it called? Oh, it's killing me. The first game I played. Prophecy of the White Witch. Hold on, I'll find it. I'm just quickly looking at my own channel to see this here. Right. Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Yeah. So I'm looking at this and guessing that's, you know, one took place on the left, one on the right, and we're here where we are. It's a breathtaking scenery. It's an exquisite view, says McBain. The north is that direction, right? Says Forte. McBain says, that means we are looking down the view opposite of backbone of the Great Serpent. Crimpa Max, says Una, which continent is it over there? I don't think it's Weltluna. I didn't even think there was a world other than Weltluna. McBain says, this is the first time for me to see it too. Una says, I can't believe there's a world I didn't know spreading on the other side of backbone of the Great Serpent. Forte says, I wonder what kind of lives the people over there are having. It's amazing to find a place where we can see such a beautiful view, says McBain. Still, I'm so excited to find out there's another world beyond the backbone of the Great Serpent. They're all saying the same thing. So, Weltluna is this world. I forget the names of the other worlds. I'm not looking those up right now. Orb of Ocean 26. Image of Aria. Oh, there she is, huh? Alright, so let's just see if it... Wow, I love the scrolling in the background. That's some parallax scrolling for you right there. It smells like fresh baked bread, says Forte. It does, says Una. The village old man says, we maintain self-sufficiency except for the tool shop and exchange stuff between us. That's why we bake our own bread. We have a long history of making it, so it's very delicious. Come over. McBain says, then why don't we accept his offer and stop by a little? Absolutely. Try some. Forte and his friends receive fresh baked bread. This looks good, says McBain. Chestnut bread, Una says. Here, Jen, Rick, open your mouth. Thank you, says Forte. Forte and his friends ate delicious, fresh baked bread. Huh? Says Forte. This taste is... The same as Matthew's bakery, says Una. What's wrong? Says McBain. You look surprised.
I was surprised because this is too delicious, says Forte.
The chestnut bread is awesome, Una says.
Good, good. No one can compete with me as far as chestnut bread making goes. Ha ha ha. I may not look like it, but I've got over easily 100 of baker disciples.
Well, we know a place that might be able to compete. Back in Gagharv. Curious to see which bread would win, right? Back here. My grandpa's chestnut bread is the best. He's getting in our way. The bread that my grandma bakes is the best, but I wish he wouldn't be carried away like that.
You mean carried away?
By inviting us in? That was nice of him. Okay, so over here we've just got the bread shop, the view. And this building, wait a second. What's that? Oh no, there's a, okay, never mind. Oh right, this is before, never mind. I don't know why for some reason I thought I went into a different zone when I went over here. No, I did not. I did not. We'll just slide down here and go wee off into oblivion. Alright, it looks like this is the last place then. Alright.